Canelo Berlanga prediction.
Canelo, no.
Fácil, no fácil.
Fácil.
Easy. All right, there you have it. Canelo Berlanga.
Canelo Berlanga. That's gonna be a very tough fight. That's gonna be a very good fight. Because Berlanga is young, so we're gonna give him the benefit of the doubt. And he knows how to knock guys out. So I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt on his feet to stay for that. Canelo's a monster. If Canelo chooses to turn it up, I mean, it could be a very ugly fight.
Who's fighting Berlanga next? What do you think? And how do you see the fight unfolding? For me?
I think, you know, being that it's always Mexico versus Puerto Rico rivalry, the Castro boxing fans, you know, are going to like it because it's always...
Canelo.
Canelo and Puerto Rico always supports their fighters, especially when they're fighting a Mexican, especially on such a big fight like this. But people that know boxing are not, you know, I don't mind the fight either, you know, but it's not something that I was really excited about. It's not a fight that I was really excited about. I know the casual, just boxing fans that love to watch boxing, they're gonna love it because Puerto Rico versus Mexico. People love to see Jake Paul fight, you know, and he generates a lot. So pretty much the same thing. I would have preferred Canelo fighting a different name, but
okay. What's your prediction?
I think Canelo knocks him out.
What round do you think?
I don't know what round.
Berlanga has power.
And Berlanga has game too. He's, you know, I'm not trying to say he's not good or he doesn't deserve it. Fuck it, he got it and
let him make his money.
Let him make his fucking huge payday. But I think Canelo wins.
Canelo's about to fight a Puerto Rican. Tell me about the Mexico Puerto Rico rivalry.
This is a Canelo.
Si se puede.
Close friend of mine.
What round does he win? Do you think?
He will make it on the 9th. Knockout.
9 knockout. Why are Mexicans so great in boxing? Chavez, Salvador Sanchez.
We have the size. We have the right size.
Finito Lopez.
That's it. So we have had a lot of champions all throughout in many, many years. And we keep having.
Who's your favorite champ?
Canelo is my closest friend. I really know him. He's from Guadalajara.
He's a great person. I've known him 15 years. He's never changed.
Yes,
but he's very, very successful. What do you love about him?
The way he boxes and his personality, the same. He can be very popular out on the street as he is in the ring.
You know, he just donated $70 million from his own money to open up a center for disabled children in Mexico.
The more you give, the more you receive.
Canelo Berlanga.
Really, I don't like to see the fight.
Why?
Because I prefer to see Crawford Canelo and Benavides Canelo. You know,
okay.
Better fight is world champions. I don't think anybody want to see this fight. I like Berlanga. He's really a good fighter. I don't think he have the resume to fight Canelo, you know, because this, you know, look, if Canelo beat Benavides of Crawford, man, you know, it is go to other level, you know what I mean? Like Mayweather, Pacquiao, he can win 50, 60, 70 million for fight, so he need to take a risk, and if he lost, he wins too.
Yeah.
So. I like Canelo to take this kind of risk. I don't know why fighting Bebo, that's the fight. And I don't know why he fight Bebo because he's the style. He's not, don't have name. So I think he can beat Benavides and beat Crawford and Canelo go to other level.
Who wins Crawford Canelo?
Canelo. I think Canelo, man, because, you know, Crawford maybe is now a little better the skill fighter than Canelo, but Canelo is a strong,
big, and Crawford's 37, 38, yeah.
Maybe he's doing good, like, 6-7 rounds, like, can, and Canelo win the fight.
And Benavidez Canelo?
Well, that's an interesting fight, because the thing is, Benavidez put a lot of pressure all the rounds, so I see Benavidez maybe decision or Canelo. Yeah.
And Canelo continues to take the fights that nobody wants to see. That takes me to Edgar Berlanga, who is fighting Canelo on September 14. Now he claims he has a whole country behind him. Edgar, bro, you're from Brooklyn. I think I'm more Puerto Rican than you are, and I only lived there for 6 years. Puerto Rico doesn't claim you, bro. And as I said weeks ago, this fight will not do well on September 14. Not only because the matchup is okay, but because they're going up against the UFC's debut at the Sphere in Las Vegas. Now that's a spectacle that everyone and their mother has been waiting to see since it opened up about a year ago. And who is funding it and making it all happen? Turkey Ala Sheikh. Canelo, you're really making the wrong enemies. But you know what? Fuck you.
Any chances for Berlanga to beat Canelo?
I wish we could beat him so he can take all the belts and maybe we have more opportunities, because right now Canelo does whatever he wants and he says that he'll do whatever he wants and he's doing it. So people don't like that anymore. So we need to get those belts, you know, in order to get better fights, because right now those fights that Canelo is getting, I don't think they're interesting. They're not exciting. And I don't think they really want to see those fights.
Berlanga, he finna get smashed this fight. So
you think so?
Do you think so?
It's a 50-50 fight.
It's a 50-50 fight. I know you lying. He be lying behind that camera, y'all. He bushing. He know he going for Canelo. He lying behind that camera. Canelo gonna smash him, bro.
Your prediction?
Canelo.
Decision or knockout?
Knockout.
What round?
Within like 3 rounds. I think Canelo by knockout, probably like 6 or 7.
Canelo Berlanga.
Canelo.
Canelo. How many rounds?
4.
What about Berlanga's power?
Yeah, power, but Canelo could take punches, you know.
So he said 4, he said 3.
I give him 6.
6?
Yeah.
It's a good fight. I mean, Canelo fights is good. I'm happy for Berlanga. He's going to, you know, get the opportunity to be on the speed.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't touch each other.
I'm scared of you. You think I'm scared of you? You think I'm scared of you? You think I'm scared of you?
Also, how does a win change your career over a guy like Canelo?
Coming in as far as the compassion, I already knew he was going out there when he was on the gut.
Man, it wasn't going to change his life.
I'm Puerto Rican. I'm Puerto Rican. I'm saying Mexican. And you know how that shit go. You know how that shit go. Every
you don't going to do anything.
Make me say, Canelo took the fight.
Anything. You don't going to do nothing.
Not give a fuck out.
You just going to make me laugh.
You're not going to fuck out. Watch. Watch my word.
Hey. Shut the fuck up. I want to see that.
Shut up. When I talk, shut up.
I don't want to shut up. I don't want to shut up.
Canelo.
When I talk, shut up. Canelo.
Hey, what? And then what? What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
Fuck you.
What are you going to do?
Sit down.
I don't want to fuck you up right now because your money is gone. If I fuck you up right now, your money is gone.
la mierda, huevota, ¿oíste?
Mierda la que me va a
hacer. Sí, vamos a sacar la mierda. Vamos a sacar la mierda. Con Glocorio, ¿oíste? Para que lo sepa. Para que lo sepa.
Alright, guys, we're gonna put this out there right here. You heard the war of words between these two main event fighters, September 14th, Mexican Independence Day weekend, Canelo Promotions, Salvador Alvarez, Edgar Berlanga. You're seeing it's getting heated. We're just a little over a month away from the showdown. I cannot wait. Mexico is Puerto Rico. Main event, September 14th. Don't miss it.
Don't beat them up.
Hey Canelo, not bad for a fight, nobody they Canelo, can you believe people complained about this fight? It's going to be the biggest fight in the last 10 years.
People always complain for everything, but I'm happy. I'm happy. I like this kind of fights.
It's going viral.
He's going to feel pain, a lot of pain. Like I said, Saul, to him, he needs 20 like him.
Why do you think he snapped?
Saul. I don't know, maybe nervous, maybe fear, maybe, I don't know, but...
Saul, ya se hizo.
I don't know what he thinks.
Saul, ya se hizo más personal.
No va a pasar de 8.
En 8.
No va a pasar de 8, pero por eso es 8 rounds lo voy a hacer que sienta mucho dolor.
¿Por qué crees que se puso a hablar?
Nervioso, no sé por qué se puso a hablar.
Saul, es más personal ya, ¿no?
Ya veremos a ver quién es.
Edgar, he predicted an 8th round knockout. What's your prediction? First of all, how are you doing today? That was exciting. I loved it. It sold the fight. So you say 6? Why 6?
6 because he got 8 and I got 2. So I took the 2, so now I got 6.
Okay, he said you're doing this for payday. What's your range? What's your action? You always have it. Look at your chains.
Come on, bro. Payday what? We don't need them. Look who I got here. Look who I got here, bro. Look, put it again. Look, that's Keith Conley, bro.
That's Keith Conley.
Look,
we got the same lawyer. You heard me, Canelo. But
Mr. Smith.
But
it was supposed to happen.
Come on, bro.
It was meant to happen.
Come on, bro.
Why is this energy in this press conference different than the New York one?
Fucking, we already signed the fight September 14th. So, and like I said, when he said, "Oh, I'm not gonna have no compromise," so this is the problem the fighters get. They go, "Let me be nice to Canelo. Let me be a gentleman, so he don't gotta hurt me in the ring." Crazy out of your mind, bro. You damn well going there like, oh, let me just, you know, be respectful. And if he laughs in my face and if he tries to take the shine, and I'ma just be respectful to know, bro. Don't work like that. Like, I'm that nigga, man.
But you got the fight by working at. You were at Canelo's fight. You worked the crowd. You were playing Spanish music. I mean, Mexican music.
I love Mexican music. Yeah.
Who's your favorite?
Vicente.
Jefe la Jefe.
Oh, yeah. That's my favorite.
So you worked hard, and very few times fighters get the fight they dream of. And you got it. How are you able to pull this off?
It just all came together.
And after today, I told Canelo, people said they don't like the fight. Everyone loves the fight right now. Yeah, it's on and everyone's going to tune in.
Come on, bro. Everybody's going to tune in. But then that's why I was telling him, yeah, I got to chill because this fight, everybody, you know, I'm on like everybody, the top four most hated. See, Puerto Rico.
Who else is up there with you most hated?
Me, it's me, Shakur, right? It's me, Shakur, Devin Haney, Ryan Garcia, and I think that's like the top four. Like,
how does that feel? Eight.
I love it. I text Shakur the other day, because you know,
I know
you guys don't have like a relationship with social media. Like me and Shakur have a real personal relationship.
For years.
Like, I'm amateurs, yeah.
But like, no, me and him like text each other, like I tell him real shit. Like we talk to each other like brother to brother. And that's my brother. So when I seen all the hate and I seen going crazy, I said, yo, you did it. He's like, what you mean, bro? I'm like, you did it. You got the attention you need. Like, whether it's good or bad press, it's still press. So that's good money. You gotta just take. I text them and I can show. I told them you gotta take advantage of this, bro. Now you gotta become the villain. Now you gotta take over boxing. Now you gotta choke this shit. Now you gotta wear your jewelry. Now you gotta put on and because now you got the spotlight on you.
By the way, you wanted to fight with Plant. You had a run-in with him. How did you? What happened today with him?
He's a bitch. He's a whore.
Why?
Because he just wanted to take everybody's spotlight. Like he just want to be in the scene. Like he want to be everywhere. Like, you want to be in Canelo and who he is, weighing. Why you at the weighing for? Nigga, like, you're a white boy, bro. Like, fuck out of here. You're not Latino. You're not Puerto Rican. You're not Ecuadorian. You're not fucking Mexican. You're nothing. You're a white boy, bro. Why you in the weighing for?
My last question. You're not going to see Canelo till fight week. What's your message to Canelo right now if he's watching?
Hell yeah, I'm knocking him out in six rounds. He said eight, I'm doing six.
Hey, guys, we got to go.
I don't want to fuck you up right now because your money is gone.
So,
I'm going to take your place, papi.
Then your money is gone.
Puerto Rico,
if I fuck you up right now, your money is gone.
Yeah. He's a gentleman. Que viva Puerto Rico, puñeta. Somos guerreros,
puñeta, la que me vas a hacer.
Vamos a sacar la mierda, hueputa, oíste.
Puñeta, la que me vas a hacer.
Sí, vamos a sacar la mierda. Vamos a sacar la mierda. Main event, September 14th. Don't miss it.
I mean, as far as the compassion, I already knew he wasn't going to have that with me from the get-go.
Better whether I'm going to change his life with that money.
I'm Puerto Rican. You know what I'm saying? He's Mexican. And you know how that shit go.
Fuck you up.
You know how that shit go.
Every
you don't want to do anything.
Puerto Rican
you don't
want to
do
anything.
Anything.
You don't want to do nothing.
Shut the fuck out.
You just gonna make me laugh.
We're gonna knock you the fuck out. Watch. Watch my word.
Okay.
Shut the fuck up.
I wanna see that. I wanna see that.
Shut up. Shut up. When I talk, shut up.
Shut up. I don't wanna shut up.
Shut up.
I don't wanna shut up.
When I talk, shut up.
I don't wanna shut up.
Canelo.
When I talk, shut up.
Canelo. And then what?
When I talk, shut up.
And then what? What are you gonna do?
And then.
What you gonna do?
Fuck you.
What you gonna do?
All right.
What you gonna do? I don't want to fuck you up right now because your money is gone. So,
I'm going to take your place, papi.
Then your money is gone.
Puerto Rico,
if I fuck you up right now, your money is gone.
Is that gentlemen? Que viva Puerto Rico, puñeta. Somos guerreros,
puñeta, la que me
vas a hacer. Somos guerreros, oíste. Somos guerreros. Vamos a sacar la mierda, hueputa, oíste.
Puñeta, la que me vas a hacer.
Sí, vamos a sacar la mierda. Vamos a sacar la mierda. Los borios, oíste. Para que lo sepa. Para que lo sepa.
All right, guys, we're gonna stop it right there. You heard the war of words between these two main event fighters, September 14th.
Some of them in English. We like you in English.
Yeah.
We like you in English. Let's try it again. But this time, think about it. What's one thing people don't know about you?
But one thing. I think people know everything. Huh? I'm multi things guy. I can do many times, many things.
Maybe something about your travels. You travel the world. We see your pictures.
Yeah. I don't like to travel.
You
really,
don't?
No. And my wife always say, we need to travel, and I don't like it. And I go, just okay.
Canelo, do you think you'll ever get to 100 fights? You're at 60 fights. Will we ever see you do another 39?
It's so hard to say. 39 is a lot of fights.
I'll say every fighter, 135 to heavyweight, is calling out Canelo. Why is it? Why does everybody want to fight Canelo Alvarez?
Payday.
And I'm
the face of boxing.
Crawford wanted a payday, but Crawford didn't do good at 54. When I talk to people, they all tell me you would have knocked him out at 68.
Well, he knows now. He experimented the 154, and he knows. He knows. Maybe he do in 168 for the payday, for a big check.
My last thing, Canelo, you just donated $70 million to build. You donated $70 million to build a center for kids with special needs in Mexico. Tell me about it. Why do you do that?
I always try to help people.
Why?
And I don't like to respond this kind of thing because I don't like to put myself like I help. I help from the bottom of my heart.
Pues very nice.
Mucha mierda, Conor McGregor diciendo que tú no puedes vender y que si es un error la que tú estás haciendo la venta en septiembre. ¿Qué piensas eso? ¿Y qué mensaje le
quieres decir? Lo que pasa es que le está ayudando a Dana White para vender la bio. Sí, pero él sabe que es mi hijo.
Para en vivo. Saúl. Gracias, Raúl. Nos encontramos aquí con Saúl El Canelo Álvarez. Saúl, antes que nada, gracias por el tiempo para Grupo Fórmula. Una conferencia medio calientita, ¿no?
Así es, no, es un placer aquí estar contigo. Y pues sí, ahora sí que se calentó todo. Berlanga y empezó a hablar mucho, pero pues ahora sí que al son que me toquen bailo.
¿Cómo se puede enfrentar a una persona que lleva 17 knockouts en 22
años? Pues mi experiencia, mi talento. También soy una persona fuerte también. Todo va a salir a relucir el día 14.
Marco Verde va a buscar la medalla de oro.
Así es, muy contento, muy orgulloso de Marco Verde. Sé que va a ganar la medalla de oro y me siento muy orgulloso de él.
Gracias, Saúl. Pues ahí están Raúl, Enrique, Rol Eduardo, las palabras de Saúl El Canelo Álvarez hablando para la Fórmula Es Deportes a través de la Fórmula. Es la información. Regresamos con ustedes hasta la Ciudad de México.
At 175. Just, what did you think he looked like, and what does he have to do to get a Canelo fight?
No, look, he's weight class. 75 is his weight class, and
And you know, he do nothing in 175, really. No, he's not the same, but he's a weight class, the 175. And I don't really want to say what he need to do to have the fight. Like I say, if the money is right, I mean, I always fought with everybody you ask, Golovkin, everybody you mentioned me. So, but now, it's the time to ask for me, right? If they want me to fight them, they need to pay me good. Like we see Benavides the last fight, yes.
Canelo, after Saturday, would you say Crawford is not for pound or is excited?
Because
he fought down
the best. He's great. He's one of the best pound for pound. Yeah, for sure.
Canelo, normalmente hablas en serio, pero hoy te vi sonriendo, riendo mucho. ¿Qué tiene de diferente esta pelea y este oponente que te hace reaccionar así, tan calmado?
No, pues obviamente... mi seguridad, ¿no? De lo, sé lo que soy como peleador, sé lo que es, y al final de cuentas, pues, no es nada nuevo para mí.
Gracias.
Canelo, ¿por qué tanta risa con él y más por parte de él? ¿Qué piensas de su técnica que tanto te aburre?
No, pues, al final de cuentas, es les duele más cuando te ríes y cuando estás tranquilo, ¿no? Al final de cuentas, ¿qué me gano enojando? ¿Qué me gano enojándome? Ya si hace otra cosa o que me quiera golpear, pues, no, si le...
Muchos no lo quieren. ¿Piensas que ya lo vas a correr del deporte porque muchos no lo quieren?
Pues esperemos que sí, lo vean, lo retire.
I gotta know, is Donnie Yen on Dana White putting the UFC 306 on the same night as your fight? What do you make of that? Because that's always been, it's kind of become your, you know, your weekend.
No, I don't have problem with that. I'm good. I'm just doing my thing, and I don't have problem with Dana, and I don't have problem with the UFC. I think we're gonna. We both want to have to sell in September 14th.
Canelo, do you think he's making this personal by talking what he's talking?
Yeah, about? It's personal, yeah.
Okay.
For me, I'm not mad, but I'm excited to put my hands on.
Canelo, would you sit down with Canelo Shake again?
Huh?
Would you speak to Canelo Shake?
With what?
Would you sit down and speak to him about the fight down the line?
Oh, no, they text me yesterday if we want to meet, if we, they have the opportunity to meet here to talk about the next fight. And I say, look, I'm focused 100% on this fight. I don't want to talk about any other fight.
Canelo.
Me pasa a la gente que se pone nerviosa, empiezan a hablar y querer como intimidar, pero es algo, no es algo nuevo para mí.
¿Esta pelea que va a significar para México?
No, va a ser una gran pelea, ya es historia, ¿no? Porque hemos visto muchas peleas entre México. Ya, ¿no? Pero al final de cuentas, cuando estás dispuesto a darlo todo y estás enfocado así, tiene un rival muy diferente a los que ha tenido en toda su carrera.
Saúl,
dale.
Una pelea de mexicanos puertorriqueños que se te haya quedado grabado desde niño.
La verdad es que no alcancé a ver muchas, entre puertorriqueños. Vi la de Miguel Ángel Cotto contra Margarito. He visto videos, obviamente, de peleas, pero de Luis César Chávez contra Chapo Rosario. Contra Salvador contra Wilfredo Gómez. Esas peleas sí las alcancé a ver. El travieso con Vázquez. Entonces, con Wilfredo Vázquez. Y he visto y sé la historia entre México y Puerto Rico.
¿La pelea del 14 de septiembre podría convertirse en un clásico? En pues, esta con Berlanga.
Ojalá que sí, todo depende de la pelea. Yo creo que ya se convirtió por todo el... lo que habló, ¿no? Ya se está convirtiendo
en... Saúl, habla de más. Edgar
¿Se ha visto que no tiene buena quijada? ¿Crees que lo puedes, como tú dices, lastimarlo para acabarlo antes de los ocho?
Sí, eso es lo que voy a, hacer el...
Bro, what are you doing, bro? Move!
Eso es lo que voy a hacer el 14 de septiembre. El 14 de septiembre lo voy a noquear, lo voy a hacer que sienta dolor por ocho asaltos y lo voy a noquear.
El papá está entrando, le dice que también que te va a noquear en el primer asalto o algo, que la verdad nunca han visto que están lastimados. ¿Qué le dices al papá? Que sabes que él no pelea por él.
No tengo nada que decirle al papá, al final de cuentas el hijo es el que se va a subir al cuadrilátero. Papá, ¿qué puedo decirle mientras tanto para seguir?
Como siempre, Saúl, levantando la bandera de México arriba de todo el mundo. El Turqui dice que ya quizás no planea trabajar contigo. ¿Qué opinas de esa situación?
No, está bien. Ayer me mandaron mensaje que querían hablar conmigo, que querían sentarse a hablar conmigo para arreglar la pelea en febrero. Les dije que no podía porque estaba enfocado 100% en esta pelea, que no era posible poder hablar de otra pelea. Y yo creo que por eso salió a decir hoy que ella no es. Y no tengo problema con eso. Como te digo, no me gusta la manera en cómo hace las cosas. Y como lo dije ayer, o sea, no... No, la verdad que muy contentos de Marco, lo hemos estado apoyando desde el principio de que empezó los Olímpicos y muy contento, yo sé que va a ganar oro, como le dije desde la primera vez, va a ganar la medalla de oro y muy contento y muy orgulloso de él.
¿Por qué el pique personal con Berlanga?
Pues no viste tan hablador, habla la boca.
Can you tell us
Berlanga's
reactions on you?
¿Ah?
His reactions on you, like the childish reactions?
Like a shot?
Yeah.
He's nervous. So that's why. We need to understand that.
Canelo, how does every fighter put
in defense a peleadores como personas?
Paciencia.
Mi mamá siempre me pregunta.
Les va a encantar, va a valer la pena.
Canelo, aside from going head up against UFC much, are you proud that UFC is adding the Mexican fighter into the cards?
Yeah, I'm proud about my people, my Mexican people. I'm proud about it. I don't get anything wrong with them, but I like to fight in those nights.
Canelo, why does everybody call
good?
You out?
Good.
Edgar Berlanga called you a motherfucker up on the stage. It was more respectful yesterday. Are you surprised by how he behaved?
He's nervous, and we need to understand that. He's nervous.
Back with Eddie Hearn yesterday, I know only a brief encounter. I think he still really admires you and looks up to you. Still amicable.
He loves
with Eddie,
me.
Yeah?
He knows. He knows. He just needs to talk about his fighter, but he knows. He don't even hear.
We heard in the build-up that there could be potentially Chris Eubank Jr. on this date. Were those negotiations ever realistic? We hear that he priced himself out.
Yeah, it was one of the options, but it is what it is.
So do you like it when an opponent pisses you off and gets under your skin? Do you like it when an opponent makes you mad?
I love it because then, hey, you know when somebody is under my skin, I make they pay in the hard way.
Canelo, un mensaje para Maja. Un mensaje para el olímpico Marco Verde que ahora llegó.
Nueve.
Canelo, decías que es personal.
Sí, es personal. A mí no me gusta hablar ni me gusta respetar a los rivales, eso, pero ahora sí que hay rivales con los que no se puede.
Do you believe that he will come forward and try to press you, or he will fight timid and cautious?
I don't know, but I don't care what kind of fight he brings. I'm gonna fuck that guy.
You know, when Turkey had a
shoot,
did you start to find some of his comments almost disrespectful when he was talking about eat you alive head to head on Mexican Independence Day?
Yeah,
if you're smart, you'll take the
look.
Deal.
I respect everybody. I respect everybody, but I don't like the way he talks. But it's his problem, not my problem. And I don't ask for a fight. And I don't ask for any fight. So I respect, like I say, if he wants a fight me with other guys, he needs to do it my way, not in his way.
¿Cómo logras tener la cabeza fría para que no te provoques?
Tanto tiempo, todo es...
Canelo, why does every...
Corazón caliente y cabeza fría.
Why does every fighter...
After your last fight, you looked over at Benavidez and kind of, you know, motioned to him, moved your... What were you trying to tell David Benavidez when you were in the ring after Mundia? Like, you didn't come get him?
Nothing, you know, excited there, but I don't really care. Like I say, if something good for me in the table, I mean, I don't...
Is it a thing with him where, you know, he's more of a risk than a guy like Berlanga or Munguia, so you need more money, more reward?
Yeah,
for
of
more
course.
Risk?
Like you guys asking for Golovkin, and I did. No, and it was a risk too because I'm my first fight in 160. So he just bring 25 pounds more to the table, and it's a rigged fight. But I can beat that guy. But I know, no, in that way, I always did.
Do you think in your heart it happens before you retire? Last you question. Fight Benavides?
Could be.
Canelo, how come you're the only guy in boxing?
Todas las peleas son importantes para mí.
Sí, que también que te de esa situación.
No, está bien. Está la manera en cómo hace las cosas. Para todos sale el sol, sé que mi afición está ahí siempre están ahí mis fans y todo va a estar bien. I'm the face of boxing.
No more. But Crawford didn't do good at 54. When I talk to people, they all tell me you would have knocked him out at 68.
Well, he knows now. He experimented the 154 and he knows.
Come on,
he
knows.
Maybe he do in 168 for a big check. No, but I see
different. You just donated $70 million.
You
donated $70 million to build a center for kids with special needs in Mexico. Tell me about why.
I always try to help people, why? and I don't like to respond this kind of thing because I don't like to put myself like I help from the bottom of my heart.
Canelo, estaba hablando mucha mierda a Conor McGregor diciendo que tú no puedes.
You know, listen, I don't want to talk about the crown. I don't know what I'm saying right now. You know, I'm focused on September 14th, and you know, I leave that to the fans. And I leave that to the people of Puerto Rico and all the Puerto Ricans around the world to put that out there. You know, fighters, you know, like Pedro, like Gordo, you know, like the fans, they don't. The face, you know. So, you know, after this fight, we're going to see, you know, who's the face of
fight. How do you feel representing Puerto Rico on this day? How many of you feel Mexico and Puerto Rico?
It feels amazing, man. You know, to carry your island behind my back, I'm going to have the flag, I'm going to have my people with me, man. And that gives me more energy, more strength. I feel good, man. Like, I feel excited, bro. Like, this is a moment that I've been waiting for all my life. You know, since I've been boxing since I was 6 years old, 7 years old, I started fighting. You know, and now I'm at the moment where this is the biggest moment of my life. You know, so I gotta take it and just keep going, man. You know, I'm a winner at the end of the day, and I work with God. You know, I keep God first in everything I do. You know, I know the outcome is gonna be what we want September 14th.
Who are your favorite Mexican and Puerto Rican fighters for you coming up?
Puerto Rican, Tito Trinidad. Mexican, I love Cesar Chavez.
And so far, is this period more bad blood between you and Canelo, or was there always bad blood to start with?
Yeah, it was always bad blood with him. Bro, y'all gotta understand, he's Mexican. I'm Puerto Rican, so that's already bad blood. Once you put a Mexican and Puerto Rican together, those two flags come together like this, it's war, bro. So, you know, I know the type of time it is, you know what I'm saying? I know, and this fight is up here. You know what I'm saying? It's a mental. It's not physical, it's not, oh, who's stronger, who's faster, no, it's this. You know what I'm saying?
And Caleb Plant's not on your list?
Fuck for that.
He's over here
trying to.
I'm
gonna pull his beard, I'm gonna smack him.
Oh, Berlanga, you know Canelo. Are you looking forward to that one?
I mean, it's a fight where, you know, Berlanga's making it more, you know, more intriguing as far as, you know, with the antics and his trash talk, you know, and he's kind of like, you know, got Canelo lying where he's like, okay, you know what, I'm not taking it easy on you. So, like, not that I think Canelo's going to take it easy on him anyway, but, you know, it's, you know, Berlanga is, he's a young, cocky fighter. And, you know, you kind of got to have that swag to be in this business, man. You know, you got to have that alter ego and that self-belief. And you almost got to kind of be delusional and say, I'm going to knock you out. And Canelo probably has one of the best chins in boxing. But, you know, I'm not hating on it, man. It's like,
let him make his money.
That's how you got to be, yep. Man. You know, you got to sell the fight. It's pay-per-view. So people don't want to hear, you know, as far as like... how the press conference was in New York, where it was kind of weak, and then it got heated in LA. That's right there what gets the fight, you know.
I agree, but I gotta tell you this: You were lined up to fight Canelo more than once, more than twice.
Yeah.
Did you have a sparring?
No, we never sparred.
But you had serious talks where your name came down to the wire, and then someone else, not Canelo's fault.
Yeah.
But how close were those opportunities? Were you already tasted it?
Yeah. It was at the 54-pound division. It was when Canelo was, I was number one mandatory at the 54-pound division. And, you know, it was going to happen a few times, but, you know, it just never did. You know what I'm saying? But you know, man, you know, Canelo has a legendary career, you know, future Hall of Famer. So, you know, he's in a position where, you know, he can pick and choose his fights. You know, Floyd did it. You know, a lot of good fighters did it, man. So, but it takes years of hard work and constantly being on top and being champion after champion after champion
to finally earn that spot
where you become the face of boxing in the sense of, I'm not saying that he necessarily is the guy, but he is the guy that generates the most money. You know what I'm saying? So when you're that guy, you kind of pick and choose what you want.
I know you have a great relationship with Jake Paul. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.